Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you IoT Reference Model by CISCO. So here in this video, I'll be discussing about IoT Reference Model by CISCO. And first, what I'll do is, I'll be going to explain you basic fundamentals regarding IoT Reference Model. So to understand basic fundamentals, there are a few basic points that you need to understand. Like you see, IoT system has multiple layers. So that designing of IoT system, that is kind of hierarchical, right? So there are multiple levels that is there with IoT system. Each level explains different functionalities and components of IoT network. So at each layer or at each level, there are different functionalities, right? And various components which is there with IoT network. This level includes different physical devices, connectivity protocols, data processing, and applications, right? Here, if you talk about IoT reference models, then you'll be observing it is kind of tier system, right? So these levels are also known as tiers. Tiers means hierarchical structure of IoT network. Each tier is having specific roles and responsibilities, right? Here, when we talk about IoT reference architecture, then there are many reference architecture that is available. Like different sets of applications are having different reference architecture. In this video, I'll be discussing about reference architecture of CISCO, but you should know it is not like there is only one reference architecture. There are multiple reference architecture that is available. Here, as per the applications, multiple reference architectures are expected to coexist in IoT domain. There can be many reference architecture of IoT systems for different applications. These reference architectures provides guidelines, best practices, and common patterns for designing and implementing IoT solutions. So here, with respect to reference architecture only, pattern of design that will be there with IoT reference system, right? See, model enables conceptualization of a framework. So model explains what? It explains how exactly framework is there with given system, right? To understand framework, we need to understand how reference model is there. Like with computer organization, we'll be having OSI reference model, right? Other than OSI also, there are some reference model like TCP/IP model. But OSI reference model explains how exactly computer system functions. Likewise, with IoT system, there can be so many reference models, right? That explains framework of given system, right? Here, see, reference model can be used. Reference model can be used to despite building blocks, successive interactions, and integration of various IoT components. Here in this video, we'll be understanding IoT architecture with CISCO, and in CISCO's IoT reference model, there are 7 levels, right? So I'll explain you each and every levels in great details. So let us see how CISCO's model is there for IoT reference model. Now I'll explain you CISCO's reference model for IoT system, in which there are 7 levels. Let us discuss about level number 1. So when we talk about level 1, it includes physical devices and controllers, which is also referred as things in IoT. See, when it comes to physical devices and controllers, you can say it is embedded system, in which there will be microcontrollers or microprocessors. Along with that, we will be interfacing sensors, actuators, machines, right? And by which we will be sensing data. Those are physical data, as well as with the use of actuator, we will be giving physical response as well, right? So that comes at level 1. When you talk about level 2, so in level 2, we have connectivity. See, connectivity is there for communication and processing units. When you talk about connectivity, then you can say here we are delved to have multiple connectivity protocols, like how edge devices are communicating. That communication may happen with varieties of protocols like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, cellular network, as well as connectivity is also there with gateways and routers. So connectivity will make sure how devices are communicating in entire IoT system, right? When we talk about level 3, then that includes edge computing. See, in edge computing, we do data element analysis and transformation. Let us try to understand that with bit more clarity. See, here we are dealing with to have real-time processing. So, real-time processing that we perform with the use of edge computing, where we will be filtering data. See, when it comes to IoT ecosystem, in which there will be millions of nodes. Millions of nodes means millions of physical devices. So obviously, there will be millions of sensors, millions of actuators, right? With the use of sensors, you will be gathering the data. So out of huge data size, you will have to filter out selected data which is meaningful. So to reduce latency, we need to do real-time processing. We need to filter out data, right? So real-time processing, filtering of data, and reducing latency, that is a major task in edge computing, and by which we will be enabling faster response. We will be enabling faster response, right? Now let us discuss about level 4. So in level 4, we have data accumulation, you can say storage. So here you will be storing large data. See here, that storage of data that is been done based on the data sensed by sensors. And see, that storage that could be local or it could be there on cloud. So on cloud also we can store data, and for some applications we can store data locally as well, right? So here, large data that we'll be gathering for storage, that could be locally stored or it could be there on cloud. Now let us discuss about level 5, that is data abstraction. Here we perform aggregation and access of data. See, you are having huge data in IoT ecosystem. The reason is, in real time, we are continuously sensing data. Data of temperature, data of moisture, data of weather, data of many things, right? So that data aggregation and access is very essential. Why? The reason is, we need to sort out the data. So data is getting sorted first, right? After that only, meaningful access to the data will be there. Otherwise, if you access all the data together, then your response will get slower. So you will have to sort out the data. You will have to identify what are the meaningful data. Out of that only, we need to provide response to the actuators, right? So data sorted, then data aggregation is happening, and easier and meaningful data access, that is the major task which we perform at data abstraction. Now at level 6, we have application. See, here when we talk about application, then in application, we majorly focus on software application. And that software application, that could be managed at internet level. So to manage that at internet level, we are having many algorithms. And those algorithms can be managed by big data analytics. It could be managed by machine learning, it could be managed by artificial intelligence, right? And by those algorithms, we control application. Here, our major focus is there on software application, right? And that software application optimization, that we do it by so many technologies available nowadays. As I have told you, we can use machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence, right? Big data analytics. These are the current technologies which we use it to optimize our application. Right. So here in application, reporting of application, analysis of application, and controlling of application that we perform, and our major focus that is there on software application, and by which we control entire application. Right. At level 7, we have collaboration and process. Here we are involving people. The reason is, at last people will be using application. So it is very essential you should involve people. Once you involve people, you can run business properly. So there is a need of collaboration. If you collaborate with the companies, more people will get involved. And as more people are getting involved, that application is having meaningful insights, meaningful access to the people. As if you have large people accessing particular application, then definitely that application can grow in future. If people are not there, then obviously nobody will be going to use it, right? So human-centric workflows and business collaboration, that comes at level 7. So that is how 7 levels are there with IoT reference model by Cisco. And this is one reference model that many industries are using nowadays for IoT application. I hope you have understood this. If anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.